Hello friends, welcome to Sunil Engineering Academy. This is Bharat. We are looking into the geography series of lectures, and in this video we are going to see earthquakes and volcanoes. The phenomenon of earthquakes and volcanoes is seen here. What are earthquakes? Sudden tremors or shaking of the earth's crust is called earthquake. And seismology is a special branch of geology which deals with the study of earthquakes, friends. So you have to remember this: seismology is the study of earthquakes, friends. So there are two scales which is useful for the measure of intensity of the earthquake, and one is of magnitude of the earthquake. Here Richter scale is the instrument which measures the magnitude of the earthquake, which ranges from, the scale ranges from 0 to 10. Mercalli scale is the instrument which measures or records the intensity of an earthquake, ranges the scale from 1 to 12. So if the question comes like, the scale which is used to measure the magnitude of the earthquake is Richter scale. If the question comes like the scale which is used to measure the intensity of the earthquake, then it is Mercalli scale, friends. So seismograph is the graph which records the waves reaching the earth surfaces, friends. So there are some waves which is related to the earthquake, friends. So you have to remember that in internal structure of the earth, we have seen that the discontinuities between the layers, that is from between the mantle and crust, between the outer core and inner core, between the outer core and the inner mantle. So all these discontinuities is known with the help of these waves, that is earthquake waves, that is called seismograph, friends. These are called seismic waves. The energy wave which are released in all directions when the earthquakes occur is called seismic waves, friends. Usually this occurs in the lithosphere. What is lithosphere? We have said that the crust and the upper, the hardest part of the upper mantle, till that it is called a lithosphere. This lithosphere is usually on the asthenosphere, which is the semi-liquid part of the mantle, friends. So this lithosphere will be practically floating on this asthenosphere or magmatic chamber. So this is the lithosphere, which refers to the portion of the depth up to 200 kilometers from the surface of the earth. So this lithosphere will be of height of 200 kilometers, friends. The point which the energy is released is focus, and also called hypocenter. And the energy waves traveling reaches the surface. Here you can see if this is earth, friends. If this is earth, and somewhere here the earthquake occurs, and that part is called focus or hypocenter. And all the waves travel in all the directions, friends. As soon as the earthquake occurs, these waves disperse from that place and moves in all the directions. So the nearest surface of the earth, it reaches some one point, friends, and this point is called epicenter, and this point is called hypocenter. So now you have come to know. See, friends, I will explain again. This is the earth, and this is the focus where earthquake occurs, and this point is called hypocenter. This is called hypocenter. The energy which is released and the waves touches the nearest part of the surface, and this part is called epicenter. It's called epicenter, friends. So these are called body waves, and after touching the surface of the earth, this point releases another set of waves. These flows on the surface of the earth, and this is called surface waves, body waves and surface waves, friends. So we will see that seismic waves are recorded on the seismograph. Seismic waves are mainly two types, body waves and surface waves. Body waves I have explained. Body waves are generated at the focus and travel all the directions, reaches the surface of the earth and generate new set of waves and which are move along the surface. These waves is called surface waves. So is the earth and is the focus. So from this focus the body waves touches the surface of the earth. As soon as it touches, there is another new set of waves which are generated. This moves along the surfaces. These are called surface waves. Surface waves, friends. So the two types in body waves, we have two types of waves, that is P waves and S waves. P waves are called primary waves and S waves is called secondary waves. And P waves or primary waves move faster and first to reach the surface. So P waves are similar to the sound waves. Sound waves can travel in gas, liquid, solid materials. In all the materials, sound can travel, friends. And S waves are secondary waves. This reaches secondary to the P waves, friends. After the primary waves, secondary waves are touches the surface, friends. These are important point is that they travel only in solid medium. Only in solid medium they can travel, friends. If suppose it is traveling in the solid medium, and if the asthenosphere comes, which is of liquid form, then it will be stopped there itself. So further movement of secondary waves will not be there, friends. So the P waves and S waves help the scientists to understand the structure of the interior of the earth. So with the help of primary waves and secondary waves, scientist has found the demarcations of the discontinuities, friends. So they know here from this it is crust, from this here it is mantle. So here, from here to here, there is asthenosphere, because by using this P waves and S waves, S waves can't travel in the liquid state. So with the help of these S waves, they found that. So if it is not traveling, then there will be a liquid in between there. So by using this strategy or tactics, they found the demarcations or discontinuities in the internal structure of the earth, friends. So what are the type of earthquakes we will see? So tectonic earthquakes. The most common earthquakes are generally we see the earthquakes of due to the sliding of rocks along the fault plane, and this is called a tectonic earthquake, friends. Volcanic earthquake, we know that due to the volcanic eruptions there will be a small tremors between in and around the volcanic region or volcanic island. This is called volcanic earthquake. Collapse earthquake, in the areas of intense mining and sometimes of roofs of the underground mines collapse, causing the minor tremors, friends, and this is called collapse earthquake. These are mainly occurs in the mining areas, friends. And explosion of earthquake, when the chemical or nuclear devices used in the explosions, then the ground shakes and tremors. And in the testing of nuclear bombs, usually we see these earthquakes, friends. Reservoir induced earthquakes. Earthquakes that occur in the areas of large reservoirs are referred to the reservoirs induced earthquakes, friends. Now we will see volcanic activity. What is volcanic activity? Usually we know that there is an asthenosphere, there will be magmatic chamber, and always this magmatic chamber finds the weakest part to come out of this place, friends. So if it founds that weakest part, then it will come out. This is called volcanic activity. That's it, friends. The formation of molten material in the magmatic chamber, its intrusion through vent. Intrusion means coming out of through the vent. Expulsion of magma called lava and cooling of the lava, formation of crystal rocks. All these comes in the volcanic activity. Depending upon the volcanic activity, Volcanoes are classified into three categories, friends: active volcanoes, dormant volcanoes, extinct volcanoes. We know that what is active volcano: constantly ejecting unvolcanic material in the form of gases, liquids and solids. And more than 500 volcanoes are there in the active volcanoes are on the earth, friends. So mainly we can see Vesuvius in Italy, Stromboli in Sicily island, Etna in Italy, Mayan in Philippines and Barron in India. If the recent activity is under the 50 years or 100 years, then it is if there is a recent activity of volcano is witnessed, then it is called active volcano. What is dormant volcano? Dormant volcano in the sense, for the past 200 to 400 years, from 200 to 400 years, if there is any eruption in the volcano, but for the past 200 years there is no volcanic activity. Before the 200 years there is some volcanic activity, then it is known as a dormant volcano. Dormant volcanoes are very, very dangerous. We don't know when it will erupt, friends. So volcanoes which are silent went to hibernation for 200 to 400 years. For example, Mount Fujiyama, Haleakala in Hawaii, Krakatoa in Indonesia. These are the dormant volcano. Extinct volcanoes. These are the volcanoes which have no indication of the any eruption in the past 200 to 400. We don't have any record of the volcanic eruptions, but they are the volcanoes. They are the volcanoes, but we don't have any historical record of those volcanic eruption in the past 200 to 400 years. For example, Kilimanjaro, Emperor Seamount chain of Hawaii, and Zuidwal in Netherlands. These are the volcanoes which are said to be extinct. Even these also are, we don't know when it will erupt, and these are also dangerous volcanoes, friends. So volcano eruption, if you come to volcano eruption, you know that it is a pouring out of molten rock coming out of through a pipe from underneath the earth is called vent. Okay, friends, here you can see so what is a volcano? So there will be a magmatic chamber. From this, the magma will intrude outside, and this part is called vent, and this is called crater or crater lake. And from this magma, when comes out, it is called lava. So this is said in the volcanic eruption, friends. It causes from the magmatic chamber, and it is from the magmatic chamber is nothing but the asthenosphere. The opening of the pipe or mouth of the, see friends, in the opening of the, there will be some lake kind of place is formed at the opening, friends, and this is called crater. This is also very much important, friends. The mouth of the vent in the volcano is called crater. The classification based on the type or mode of eruptions, friends. Explosive volcanoes and silent volcanoes. See, the explosive central volcanoes, in the sense, this type of eruptions is sometimes very explosive because lava, steam, gas, dust, smoke, stone fragments are ejected from a narrow pipe from under the ground with greater intensity, friends. So with great intensity, if this is rushed out, and with all the lava, steam, gases, smoke and everything causes, and these are called explosive volcano, friends. And lava is this type of volcanoes, mostly this lava is acidic in nature. Examples are Kilimanjaro, Fujiyama, Vesuvius and Mount Etna. See, these are acidic lava volcanoes, and these comes up out with an explosion, friends. There are another type of volcanoes. These are silent volcanoes or fissure volcanoes. What are fissure volcanoes? There will be cracks on the ground. From these cracks, one side this lava comes out without any sound or anything, any hangama without any sounds or any blasts, this lava oozes out something like it comes, water is coming out some place or something like that. Through these fissures, cracks, this lava oozes out, friends. This type of lava is mostly basic in nature. Basic in nature, friends. Okay, the long fissures or cracks develops in the ground and also deep enough that molten lava oozes out along with the steam, grass or rock fragments, friends. This lava cools down on the ground or a period of time, mainly basalt plate. Due to this, plateaus are formed, friends. Basalt plateau are formed due to this fissure volcanoes. One of the example is our Deccan Plateau. Deccan Plateau is one of the basalt plateau or basic kind of plateau formed due to the fissure volcanic eruptions, friends. So most of the Deccan Plateau is we have black soil. We have black soil. This black soil and this basaltic rocks are formed due to the once upon a time volcanic eruption, that is a fissure volcanic eruption, which is of basic in nature, friends. Okay, and another example we can give is Hawaiian type of cone. The cone which is formed in the basaltic basic lava is of the height is will be very less, but it is of Hawaiian type of cone, friends. The cone is very it's in the shape of saucer, friends. Inverted saucer. It's in the shape of, you can see, inverted saucer. Saucer plate will be like that. If it is inverted, it will be like this, friends. The cone will be of very less height, but the area is very large, friends. These, in other words, it is called Hawaiian type of cone, friends. Whereas in acidic in nature, acidic cones, the cone height will be very high, friends. See, usually there will be here in the beginning, if there is any lava coming out on the ground, it is of very it will be flat, friends. This acidic lava forms will be deposited here and here, and upon that there will be a deposition on deposition, friends. So the deposition goes on that within days time, hundreds of meters of hills are formed, friends. So in that way, this forms a big mountain. At the end of the many decades, there will be formation of big mountains, and there will be a vent, friends. So these are acidic cones, and these are basaltic cones or Hawaiian type of cones. So with this, we have learnt earthquakes, phenomenons of earthquakes, types of earthquakes and types of volcanoes and phenomenon of volcanoes. If you like this video, don't forget to give thumbs up, and don't forget to download the PDF. If you have already downloaded, please ignore this. If you not downloaded this PDF, I advise you to download, friends. Thank you. Bye bye.